Welcome back to OnSign TV Academy. In this Academy video, we'll cover everything you need to know about our new and improved playlist layout. As you'll see, there are some new features which will make it easier to build and handle your playlists, especially when it comes to large sets of data and nested playlists. So let's begin. First, create a new playlist. As you know, here you'll see the main playlist elements. We'll go over these a bit later and instead start off with the most important part of any playlist, which is the content. This is also the main difference between the old and the new playlist layout. On the left side here is the navigation panel. Here you'll access all of your files on the OnSign TV platform, so you can search up content through the search bar here. Search based on a term as well as a content type. So if you're browsing based on a content type, just enter type, colon, and then, for example, image, which will bring up all files matching to this type. Meanwhile, on the right side here is where we will be building our playlist. So let me just drag in some files first. To move items in or out of the playlist, you can tick these boxes in front of items, then use arrows to move them in or out of the playlist. You can also drag them in, which works as well. Right away, you can see that the playlist layout is a bit different than before. It shows a list, which gives you a very clear overview of all of the files within your playlist. You can change this to a grid view or even a large grid view if you want. For now, I'll stick to the list, as it shows a lot more items at once and shows more information. Firstly, these little tick boxes in front of each item are very useful. They'll let you select individual items you need and then do what you want with them. But if you want to select entire sets of files, just tick this box here and it will select everything within this folder that can be placed in the playlist. For videos, images, and apps, you also get additional information for each item. Here you can see the length and the size of each item if this information is important to you. These small icons here indicate what content type the file is. So this is a video here, this is a playlist, and so on. Next to all of this information, there is also a column for pausing content, so this prevents it from being shown in the playback. You can also apply restrictions. For example, if you have something like audio for limited time offers, or maybe music that you want to only play on weekends or during holidays, this way you can set it up so it plays only under specific conditions, and then you don't have to worry about it going off at the wrong time. By the way, to pause or apply restrictions to multiple files at once, just tick them, click on these three dots, and then select what you want to do with them. Up next, we have this gear icon column. Clicking on this allows you to adjust some settings for each file, so you can trim the duration, adjust the volume of the file, or change the transition. Now let's talk about one really important advantage of this new layout, specifically in the list view, and that is handling nested playlists. If you dragged in an already existing playlist into this one, click this arrow and you'll see all the content within it. This offers a lot more visibility than the previous version, especially if you have multiple nested playlists in one place. This column here enables you to find where each item is located on your platform. So click here on the folder icon and you'll see the hierarchy of files where this file is placed. Here you can see just how deep in my folder structure this file is. Then if I click on the last folder in line, it will open in another tab. If I click on the file itself, it will open in another tab where I can edit the nested playlist directly. Just make sure that you click on this little arrow to open in a new tab. Otherwise, if you click here, it will open in the current one. Of course, if you're going to do that, be sure to hit save first so you don't lose your progress. That's about it when it comes to importing content into your playlist. Now let's quickly talk about these settings up here. The newest addition here is the change to the playback order. Firstly, you can set the playlist to play in manual order, that is the way the items are set here. To change this order manually, just drag the individual files around. Another option is shuffled playback. This will randomize the order of files on every loop. It's a great way to present content in a more authentic way so the audience doesn't get used to the same content cycle repeating itself, so they never know what's coming up next. As for the other settings up here, as you know, you can set the default duration of media files here. You can alter the playback mode here, so you know you can leave it to play all the files in a playlist. You can set it to play on cycle mode, which plays only a specific number of files per playlist playback, or you can set it on a fixed duration. And that's pretty much everything you need to know about the new playlist layout. This playlist editor will become the default layout for all OnSign TV users, but at this time, you can click here to use the old playlist editor if you're not yet comfortable to start using the new one. The old editor will be available for only a limited time, and the goal is to eventually make the switch to this new and improved playlist layout, as it offers more features and accessibility. And that's about it for this Academy video, and I'll see you in the next one.